So hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. And today, and I'm going to dedicate my following 8 videos to my favorite brand now, Thom Browne. It is kind of like period of Thom Browne fetish, or you can call it Thom Browne fever. Actually, I found out it is a very good brand suitable for me, and a lot of Western, fashionable people doesn't really familiar with the brand, and it's very, very popular in Asia because it's very unique cutting and silhouette, which is suitable for people with a little bit, unfortunate body proportion. And what I'm going to do here is I'm gonna do 8 separate videos, and each of them will be dedicated to introduce you with one Thom Browne, pieces. First of all, what I'm gonna do today is about the shirt. So, and then next one, I'm gonna introduce you about the suit. And later on is also the third one will be about Thom Browne's very famous cardigan, and as following. So you can see here I have laid down all my Thom Browne shirt on the bed. Well, it is a lot, I know, and a lot of them are with similar style. That's also why I'm going to introduce you what do you have to pay attention when you're trying to purchase a Thom Browne shirt. So before I jump into the Thom Browne, the detail of the shirt, what I would like to first is to discuss a little bit about what kind of material you would normally find in the market about the Thom Browne shirt, and what kind of details or style you will have to choose. So first of all, the material. Thom Browne shirt comes with in 2 different material. One is the very traditional Oxford cotton. That is where you see from me. So the beauty of the Oxford material is that it is a little bit wrinkled, but when you wash it, you don't really have to iron it, and it's very durable. And it gives this Thom Browne desired a little bit vintage and wrinkle and casual look without you have to put too much attention to it.
Is that a real reason or just for lazy people?
No, it is the real reason. I think so, because every single time when Thom Browne called himself the collection and idea, the essence of the whole Thom Browne brand about the uniformity, one thing is about really not too much paying attention to the iron the shirt, but have a natural, warm and a bit wrinkled look. That's just how it is. The second material, what I don't have here because I'm naturally a lazy people, so I don't like to iron, so I never purchased that. It is the poplin material. The poplin material is a bit tighter waved with each other, and it gives the shirt a little bit more formal look, a bit more formal than what I wear today. And naturally, when it's become more formal, you have to actually sometimes to iron it and prepare before you are going to wear it. Now, these are the 2 basic material. Of course, I don't exclude some fashionable pieces in the seasons that come with silk or other, innovative material. But these 2 are normally the basic material you'll find in the Thom Browne shirt. So before you buy it, please pay attention whether the shirt is made by cotton from the Oxford, mm-hmm. or is it really made by poplin. One small trick to do is when it said made in USA, it's normally Oxford cotton, mm-hmm. and when it say made in Italy, most of the time it is the poplin.
Okay.
The second thing is, of course, everybody caring about is about the style. I would have to say the cut of the shirt of Thom Browne is always one size smaller than the normal European designer shirt. So when you are normally wear 46, I would advise you to go for 48, which is equivalent to Thom Browne size 2. Yes, 2. And then when I normally wear XS, which is a Thom Browne size 0, I goes for 1, because you can see here the shoulder and the waist cut. It is really, really, really small. The third thing you have to pay attention before you purchase a Thom Browne suit is it is very, very long. I think the bottom layer of the shirt is almost to here. That is deliberately done by Mr. Thom Browne because he doesn't advise people to wear a shirt outside the pants. So when you put the pants, put the shirt inside the pants, naturally when it's longer, it stays there. Instead of during the day, it will pop out because it's too short. So that's another attention point you have to take into consideration when if you like really the casual look and you like to put the shirt outside your pants, then Thom Browne shirt is not a very good style for you. Now we are going to talk about the style, really the style and the fashion part of the Thom Browne shirt. So The Thom Browne are very famous about its gross grain detail, which mm-hmm. you will see from this shirt. This is a typical basic collection pieces from Thom Browne. Mm-hmm. It is made by cotton, Oxford cotton, with a gross grain detail on the armband. And the idea of it is it has three buttons to adjust the width of this sleeve. So it's very unique, but I don't think it is to do with any usefulness, but I just use it as a slight detail of it.
Okay,
and this is the one stop. So you have the gross grain armband. So I have two different color. That's also sort of like Thom Browne signature color, the light blue denim,
yeah.
and then the very white or off-white, you can call it the color. The second style of Thom Browne shirt is the gross grain on the button, under the button. It goes all the way till the end.
Mm-hmm.
And when you wear this shirt, of course, Thom Browne has his set of rules how you have to wear the clothes. For example, about the shirt, I'm just gonna talk about a little bit detail. You never button the sleeve, maybe the first one, but never this one. The same here. You never button the first button as well. And then you put a tie. You never tie. You never put the tie so tight that to all the way here, but you leave a little bit space in between, but the knot of the tie has to be
mm-hmm.
extremely tight.
Okay.
And you always have to wear, a clasp. I think
yeah.
a tie clasp. And you never button up here. Yeah, another style is that all Thom Browne shirt is button down shirt, all right? So that's where this shirt come from, is that when you don't button the first one, people will see a tiny little bit of the gross grain under the button. I think it's very beautiful. And then we have one variation of the gross grain is this shirt. It's also a basic collection. So you can see, you still see the three color signatures of the Thom Browne. But if you go closer, it is not gross grain. It is an engineered cotton in between.
Mm-hmm.
So it's waved into to give a little bit less, let's say formal, less outgoing, and it's a bit discreet. There's another style. And the last style I have is the shirt I have on my body. It is also made by Oxford Browne in light. I think this is a deeper blue. And then you can see here, it comes with the signature four stripes from Thom Browne. Don't mistake with Adidas, please. Adidas is three stripes and Thom Browne is four stripes. Now, this is the shirt, and what I'm going to do now is I'll put different signature pieces from Thom Browne, so you will see how it looks like together with the whole Thom Browne outfit, a signature look. And then afterwards, I will introduce you with a second video, then I will see you next time.
Stylish, fashionable, and dapper. I
Yeah, I think the suit is the essence of Thom Browne's signature. I mean, he has been wearing suit for the last 13 years, and every single Thom Browne suit is hand-stitched and fully canvassed. So I will dedicate one full video to discuss the Thom Browne suit, and well, let's see how it comes out with it.
Yeah.
And I will see you guys next time.